Welcome to this week's virtual drasha. We have the incredible privilege this week to read Parashas Vayetze. And in Parashas Vayetze, we read of the dramatic flight of Yaakov Avinu from Canaan to Haran. He leaves Canaan because Esav is ready to kill him. So he's got to get out for his own physical, personal safety. But at least externally, the storyline is he goes to Haran in order to be able to find a wife. And on the way, the Torah tells us that he has a dramatic dream. The dream of the Sulam Mutzav Arza V'Rosha Magia Shamaima, the dream of the base of the ladder that's situated on the earth, the top of the ladder extends into the heavens, U'malachei Elokim Olim V'Yardimo, the angels going back and forth, up and down the ladder, and it's here that God speaks to Yaakov Avinu for the first time. And it's here that God introduces himself to Yaakov Avinu. I am Hashem, the God of your father, God of your grandfather. And he tells Yaakov, I'm going to be with you every step of the journey. You will never be alone. Incredible. The Talmud, the Gemara relates something absolutely amazing. The Gemara says, this is in Maseches Chulin Daf Tzadik Aleph from the base, page 91b in Chulin. The Gemara says, if you look at the pasuk, it says, Vayetze Yaakov Be'er Sheva Vayelech Harana. Yaakov left Be'er Sheva, Canaan, and he goes to Haran. And then it says, Vayifka B'makom Le'alan Shem. He slept in the place. The place, of course, is a reference to Har Moriah, Mount Moriah, the future site of the Beis HaMikdash, the site in which the Akedah, the binding of Yitzchak, took place. Remember again, it was that place, that exact spot, that Yaakov's father Yitzchak was bound on the altar by his grandfather Avram, and Avram stood ready to shecht his son. So the Gemara says something amazing, because from the first verse, it sounds like Yaakov left Be'er Sheva, and he got to Haran, right? He started at point A, he got to point B. But then it says he spent the night on Har Moriah, which is still in Canaan, still in Eretz Canaan. So what happened? So the Gemara says something absolutely amazing. The Gemara says, Kimat l'Haran. In fact, Yaakov left Canaan, and he got all the way to Haran. And when he gets to Haran, he says to himself, Oy vavoy, efshar avarti amokum shespalu avos avani lo espalati? So Yaakov says, oh my gosh, I just passed by Har Moriah. I just passed by the spot where my father, where my grandfather David, where they were united in the Akedah. I just walked right by there and I didn't even stop to David. How could it be that I missed the opportunity to worship in that sacred space? So what happens? Kad Yoav Daitel Mahadr. He decided, you know what, I got to go back. I have to go back. And the Gemara relates that there was a miracle, Kfitza Saderach, the journey contracted, and ultimately, again, he comes to the spot. He begins to daven. HaKadosh Baruch Hu causes the sun to go down a little bit early, so that Yaakov would be forced to spend the night there, and that's where the dramatic vision of the ladder and the conversation between God and Yaakov occurs. So really an incredible insight, because the Gemara understands that in reality, Yaakov left Canaan, he arrived in Haran, realized that he missed a golden opportunity to daven at Har Moriah, goes back, HaKadosh Baruch Hu intervenes, sun comes down, Yaakov spends the night, vision, ladder, Shalom al Yisrael, everything is great. And the Imre Emes, the Gerebbe, asks a simple question. I don't understand. Why didn't Yaakov stop at Har Moriah? Why didn't he stop? He walked right through it, he walked right past it, right? He's on his way from Canaan to Haran. Why doesn't he stop at Har Moriah to daven? In other words, or to ask it a little differently, the Imre Emes says, how could Yaakov have passed by that sacred spot and not stop to say a kapitel of Tehillim, a little tefillah, a chapa mincha, right? How do you just walk by that spot and not daven there? Now, obviously, he realized what he did, but he only realizes it once he gets to Haran. And then when he goes to Haran, he has to come all the way back. And now the miracles start. Kfitzas HaDerech, right? Kadosh Baruch Hu literally went ahead and lessened the journey, literally caused the earth to contract, to make the journey. Why didn't he just stop on the way out? And the Imre Emes says something absolutely amazing. The Rebbe explains that Yaakov Avinu was teaching us the power of singular vision. See, Yaakov Avinu had a mission. And what was the mission? His mother told him, you have to leave Canaan. You have to go to Haran. I want you to get married. I want you to spend Yamim Achadim, a number of days there. And that's it. Yaakov Avinu had a mission. And Yaakov Avinu, in the execution of that mission, had tunnel vision. All I see is the mission. Because Yaakov Avinu understood, if I allow myself to potentially get distracted, once you get distracted from your life mission, unfortunately, the statistical probability is that you will not fulfill the mission. So what does Yaakov Avinu do? He literally blinds himself to everything else. He puts on blinders. There's an objective. There's a mission. There's a goal. And nothing could get in my way. And says the Imre Emes, we see something dramatically amazing here. Because dear friends, how many times in life does it happen that we start out with a goal, that we start out with a mission, that I have a dream, that I have a dream. And I start on the dream, I start on the journey. And then what happens? Well, you know what happens. Generally, it usually starts with the phone rings. And then I pick up the phone. Okay, no problem. An hour later, I hang up the phone, back to the dream, back to the mission. Then what happens? Ding, there's a WhatsApp, there's a text message. Oh, you know, my friend just posted on Facebook what he had for lunch. Oh, I'm Amish, I gotta stop everything, I gotta see. What? That's the most beautiful burger I've ever seen. It's a different discussion why people feel the need to post pictures of what they're eating on social media, but we'll leave that for a different share. In any event, and then what happens? Oh, I saw my friend had for lunch. Okay, back to the dream, back to the dream, okay? Plug away with the dream, during the journey. Then what happens? Email comes in. Oh, I gotta answer this. This is important. It's this person, it's that person, it's a donor, it's a client, this is this, okay, that. But I'll finish the email. Back to the dream, back to the mission. And then what happens? A day goes by, and I've advanced 2 feet on a 100-mile journey. And this is what happens in life. Day after day, I start out with clarity of vision, but I don't put on my blinders. And because I don't put on my blinders, I get distracted. And the moment I get distracted is the moment I lose traction. You know, we are living in a world that is filled with so many distractions. I don't mean anything, you know, usher or illicit. I just mean we have diminished attention spans. And ultimately, again, and there's always something binging or pinging or ringing or something. And it just diverts my attention. And so suddenly, again, I had such incredible plans for the day. I had such incredible plans for life. But I got distracted. I got distracted. And you know, sometimes the distractions are good things also. Sometimes the distractions are davening mincha tara moria. Sometimes the distractions are not chas v'shalom, inane, foolish things like looking at your friend's lunch on Facebook. Sometimes it's actually meaningful things. But I forgot to put on my blinders. Says the Imre Emes Yaakovinu teaches us that if you want to accomplish something in life, sometimes you have to shut out everything. Now, while it's true, a lot of times in life, here I don't necessarily have that luxury to shut down everything. Sure, I'd love to shut my phone off for a day, and I'd love to not check my email for a day, and I'd love to be totally cut off for everything for a day, and I could just run and accomplish. Life doesn't often give us that opportunity, but to some degree, to put on your blinders. If you want to accomplish something in life, sometimes you have to shut everything else out. Because the moment you allow yourself to get distracted is the moment that it is almost certain you will not accomplish what you want to accomplish. And that's what Yaakov Avinu teaches us. Yaakov went from Canaan to Haran, and he passed right through Haran Moriah. How do you pass through Haran Moriah without stopping for a capital to heal him? Blinders. I gotta be focused. Singular dedication. Laser-like precision. I only see one thing. I only see one thing. My goal. All I see is my finish line. All I see is the objective, and everything else has to be shut out. If we're honest with ourselves, a lot of times the reasons we don't accomplish things we wanted to accomplish in life is because we allow ourselves to get distracted. We allow ourselves to get pulled into the various things in life which seek to divert our attention. We allow it. We allow it. So if I allow it, I can't then complain when I don't cross the finish line. I can't complain when I only advance 6 inches on what is a 6-mile journey. I can't complain when I don't reach my promised land, because at the end of the day, I didn't put on the blinders. Sometimes in life, if you want to accomplish something, you must have tunnel vision. You must have singular focus. Sometimes you have to shut off everything else in order to get where you need to get to. But Yaakov Avinu teaches us a different lesson as well. Because remember, when he gets to Haran, he turns around. He turns around. Yaakov Avinu also teaches us the power of living with intentionality. Living with intentionality means I don't just go with the flow. You know, a lot of people live life like a boat without a rudder. A boat without oars. So where does a boat, right? You have a boat without a rudder. Where does the boat without a rudder go? Wherever the waves take it. And sometimes, so many times in life, we live like that. I'm the boat on the sea, and I go wherever the day takes me. So right now, the phone is ringing, I go there. The email's pinging, I go there. Oh, someone texted me, I go there. And there's no intentionality. If you ask me, where am I going? I go wherever the waves push me. I go whatever's going on. And people do this even in more dramatic ways. Where, who are you? Well, I'm going to be whatever the people around me want me to be. So right now I'm surrounded with this chaver, they're like this, I'll be like that. Oh, this chaver, this group is like this, I'll be like that. And I'm like the rudderless boat that just goes wherever the strongest current pushes. You have to live life with intentionality. And intentionality means I make a decision about where I go and what I do. So Yaakov Avinu reaches Haran. And it's true, he reached Haran because at the end of the day, he had that singular focus to get to the destination, to get to the goal. But then he realizes, I missed out on something. So Yaakov Avinu could have easily said, oh well, better luck next time. Okay, I missed it. No. You know what? I'll eventually get back to Eretz Yisrael. I'll get there now. Yaakov Avinu chooses, no, if I miss the opportunity, if I have an opportunity to right the ship, I have an opportunity to go back, I have an opportunity to chap that mincha, to say that capital till him, I'm going back. Yaakov Avinu doesn't go with the flow, but he lives life with a sense of intentionality. I do things in a methodical way. I think before I act. I don't just allow life to happen to me. But I am the master of my domain. I am the captain of my ship. My boat has a rudder, and I choose which direction it goes in. So amazingly enough, Yaakov misses Haran Moriah because he has singular focus, which is what he needed to do at that time. But then when he gets to Haran, he realizes, oh, I missed the opportunity. And life with intentionality means just because you did things a certain way for a certain amount of time doesn't mean I have to continue to do it that way. I missed Haran. That doesn't mean that I have to go ahead and remain in this state. If I could correct it, let me go back. If I could do things a little bit differently, let me go back. And it's this two-pronged approach to a successful living that I learned from Yaakov Avinu. If you want to be successful in life, sometimes you have to develop healthy tunnel vision. Sometimes you have to put on blinders. I got to get this done. I have to, you know, we all experience this. Sometimes you have a deadline at work. And, you know, I had the same deadline two weeks ago, but I just didn't do it. So what does a person often do? You close the door to your office, you shut off the ring on your phone, and you plug away. We often only do that like in times of crisis when I'm up against a hard deadline. Imagine if I lived that way proactively. And if I decided for myself that something has to get done, I put on my blinders, singular vision, and I get it done. I will not be distracted. I will not be derailed. That's Yaakov Avinu. Vayetz Yaakov Be'er Sheva, he leaves Be'er Sheva, vayelech Haran, and he gets to Haran. Lesson number one, you want to be accomplished in life, singular tunnel vision. Lesson number two, live with intentionality. Sometimes the way that I lived my life up until now is not the way I should continue to live it going forward. Sometimes I've missed opportunities, and just because I've missed opportunities in the past doesn't mean that I should continue to miss them in the future. Yaakov missed an opportunity to be at Haran Moriah, but just because I missed it in the past doesn't mean that I can't make it up. In this case, Yaakov Avinu had the ability to go back. Living life with intentionality is about thinking, what direction do I want my boat to go in? I am not a rudderless vessel. I'm the captain of my ship. I'm the skipper. I control the rudder. I live life with an intentionality. I decide where I want to go, how I want to get there, and what I want to do. I do not let life happen to me, but I create the dynamic of my existence. These are the two lessons that Yaakov Avinu teaches us. The two lessons gleaned from just the simple opening in the parasha. Live life with singular focus, drown out distractions, and live life with intentionality. Just because I've lived a certain way in the past doesn't mean I have to continue in that direction in the future. These are the lessons that allowed Yaakov Avinu to unlock his personal greatness. And these are the lessons, ultimately, again, that allow us to do the same. Wishing everyone a guten Erev Shabbos and a beautiful Shabbos Kodesh.